Carrie, do you find that that the insomnia is different between people who aren't on HRT?
Yes, sort of. So if it's strictly a hormone issue, if she says, I've never had insomnia, I turned 45 and I got insomnia, and oh, by the way, I'm also having irregular periods and hot flashes and night sweats and all this stuff. I find that going on HRT generally resolves their insomnia. If they've had insomnia their whole life, and oh, by the way, they're having hormonal issues as well, or they're perimenopausal, going on HRT may or may not help their insomnia, because their insomnia may be induced by, of course, other things, cortisol, blood sugar, parasites, you know, thyroid, hypothyroidism, you know, hyperthyroidism. And so then I find that it's much more systemic, as opposed to just the women who say to me, I turn 40 and can't sleep, or I turn 45 and I can't sleep. I'm like, oh, perimenopause.
Yeah, I'm curious mainly because it seems like in some women, estrogen can be a cause of insomnia. So we had talked about one of my clients a while back who had estrogen through the roof for unknown reasons, and insomnia was a major thing that she was dealing with.
I could believe it. Yeah, I'm a big fan of estrogen, but it's like Goldilocks, right? Like too little is a problem and too much is a problem. But if you think about it too, like high estrogen pushes tryptophan down the kynurenine pathway and away from serotonin and melatonin. So if you have excessively high amounts of estrogen, you're going to likely make a little bit less serotonin and melatonin, and that can really affect your mood, and then it'll affect your melatonin, so your sleep.
Yeah, I was looking at a paper on this recently, and it looks like even though estrogen stimulates the beginning of the kynurenine pathway, it stimulates the end of it a lot more. Mm. And so you can, in addition to not getting melatonin and serotonin, you can get quinolinate, which can be excitotoxic or an excitatory neurotransmitter building up.